his friendship, his guidance, his wisdom to be very valuable to him. About two or three times a year, Doris Spriggs, who's here, who worked with Roger for 29 years, every three, 4 months, Paul would call us and say, come and have lunch. So Doris and I would trot over to Stanmore, and we'd have a wonderful chat with Bob in the garden, and we'd chat about the business. He never moaned about his ailments, he never mentioned he was ill, he just talked about the business, because he loved the business. And then we'd go for a lovely lunch, and a lovely pudding, wasn't it, Doris? Always a lovely sweet trolley. And it was a joy to know Bob, and I'm honoured to be here and part of this day with you all today. I think it's time to call through to our host now, so if we could call through to Roger in Monaco, and we'll see if we can have a word with him.
Are you there?
Maybe.
Good afternoon, everybody, friends and family of our friend Bob. I think Gareth has told you why he can't be there. Volcanic actions stopped the saint and stopped Bond right in his tracks. Just can't. Yeah, I used to be Simon Templer when I had a lot of hair. I had a lot of hairspray and the quiff went all the way up there. And it was the saint that brought me together with Bob, which would have been about 1961, 62, when we started Southern Thought together, and that was the beginning of a long and wonderful friendship, and then a very happy business partnership. I thought of words for Gareth to say when before we realized that I would be able to do the Skype hookup. And what I wanted to say was that Bob, when I think of him, I think the best description of him, he was a dapper man. And by dapper, I mean everything was always in place. He was always impeccably dressed, hair groomed, and his moustache always. Well, he was very handsome. And all I had to say to him was, you know, Bob, you look like Ronald Coleman. And he'd take the pipe up his mouth and his eyebrow would go slightly up and say, 'Tis a far, far better thing than I do. Oh, it was great. But being dapper, an illustration of this was, we started going on holiday together. Alma and Louise and Bob and I. And one year, I think in about the mid-60s, we went to Magaluf. And Magaluf at that time in New York, and I think there was just one hotel on the beach, and that was it. I was about to go under construction, the rest of it. But we, you know, struck up friendship with a few of the people that were staying in the hotel we could see on the beach. Bob and I always used to get up very early in the morning and go down, not to claim our deck chairs, we left that for the Germans. We would go down for our early morning swim. And one morning, Bob had not come down. I don't know what we held him up, but anyway, I had my swim and I came up, and there was one of the people we saw occasionally on the beach who said, "Where's your dapper friend?" And all he had ever seen was Bob in his swimming shorts. But Bob in his swimming shorts, with his very neat moustache and his well-groomed hair, was always dapper. He was a wonderful friend to have, a wonderful business partner. And in all the years, through umpteen saints and through the persuaders, with Tony Curtis, of course, and a film Cross Plot, which I believe Alvin, you're there, Alvin Rakoff directed. And in all those years, it must be at least 10, 12, 13, Bob and I never had a crossword. It was a wonderful, wonderful, warm, friendly family relationship. He became godfather to my daughter, Deborah. particularly friends as well, like we miss him. And I would give anything to have him say after saying, "Do you look like Ronald Coleman?" Ah, oh, it is a far, far better thing I do now than I've ever done. And it is a far, far better place I go to than I have ever been. Bob is in that better place. And we can't say come back, but I hope we will all see you. God bless you all. Thank you for coming and sharing a memory or two of dear Bob, Robert S. Baker. Thank you. Thank you, Gareth, for explaining why I couldn't be there. And thank you, everybody, for coming. Have a wonderful rest of the day.